You got the final pure heart. And this is the end of this chapter. Heroes, my daughter wanted thee to save all worlds towards the final wish. Grammy spoke slowly through his tears as the brave nimbies cleaned up the over there. Draped in sadness, Queen Jade walked slowly to her palace in the underwear. Mario, his friends, and all the eighth pure heart were all that remained. His pure heart had come at a high price, but let us hope it was all worthwhile. What? Spout Camp Black in utter disbelief. Surely this news cannot be true. The heroes still live? Oh, I'm afraid so, my count. In fact, they'll be here before long. Was it? Is that true? Then what are we doing here to another biscuit here? Camp Black, let me go throw him a nice welcome party. I'll bring the punch.
Do you want to party with this party pooper stew? What about Chunks? Me.
Well, I'm not one to miss a party.
Oh, but wait one moment, dear Count. Does the name Bloomier ring a bell?
Where did you hear that name, the Bonechill?
Oh, the mustache man's pixel went on and on. She said, I must stop Lumiere.
But I suppose there's no reason to pay any mind to the ramblings of a pixel.
Ciao for now, my counts.
Count Black, if that pixel's who you think it is, there's still time. You can still stop the prophecy from destroying everything.
Yeah, because if that's really her, if she's alive, you have to stop all of this.
You know not what you are saying, Nastasia. The prophecy can no longer be stopped by Count Black. No one can stop it.
Yeah, I'm on board with that, what you're saying. But there must be a way. There must. Lord Lumiere.
Man known as Bloomier died long ago. Now there is only a dark prognosticus is a choice to fulfill the prophecy. Nothing more.
But
come to Camp Black, heroes. If you hope to save these worlds, then come. Ech.
Thank you. What?